Alright, here we go. Sorry.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
After all these years, I'm just a glorified mic stand. Anyways. Well, thank you guys for sticking around with you guys together for El Dorado Jazz 1. That is the title of WhirlyBird. And we heard from Sam Hatsuma on the tenor saxophone. Also, Joseph Rojas over here on the tenor saxophone. And a little bit of Owen Crail back there on the drums. All right, now we're going to feature Anthony Elias on the very saxophone. As well as Betty Kruth on the lead trumpet. And Spencer Marr on the trombone. On a great shuffle entitled The Chopper.
Thank you.
we're going to now play a tune by the great late Sammy Nestico. And we're going to feature Kit Kawada on the trumpet on this track. We're going to hear from him a little bit later, but we're going to feature Spencer Marr on the trombone. Both Kit Kawada and Spencer Marr and Benny Caruth.
Anthony.
We're members of the SES Joy All-Star Honor Jazz Band program this year.
We're standing. Yeah,
I forgot to mention Luke Caruth from Jazz 2 and Miles Olson, who's playing trumpet up here. We're also part of the Honor Jazz Band, so we've had great representation for El Dorado in those programs. It's been awesome. And Spencer, on another note, after the Irvine Jazz Festival performance, he earned a full-ride scholarship to the Stanford Jazz Workshop up in Northern California this summer, so he'll get to spend time with some amazing musicians, educators, and all full rides because of how great I have taught him. No, I'm kidding. How great he has played and how his private instructors helped him and just how much he's worked and practiced, and he's just great representation of all of our kids. So this is Spencer Marr, ladies and gentlemen, on Downtime. And on this tune, I'm even going to let him count the band off so I can go eat. Here we go.
One, two, three, four.
Mr. Marr on the trombone. All right, we're gonna. Wasn't that a great tune?
Yes.
Just put a smile on your face. It's a feel-good tune. This is another one of those tunes. This is titled "So Easy." Just like this job, you know. So easy. Come on, drummer. Sorry, it's a pressure. It's all good. We're going to feature Joseph Rojas again on tenor saxophone. Pete Kawada again on the trumpet. And I think Josh Knight on the piano here, right?
Yeah.
This is a tune entitled "So Easy." We are here because of Friends of Jazz. We'd like to bring up a representative of Friends of Jazz. He's been a good friend of our programs. His son is also a band director in Anaheim, so he knows all about this, and he's here every Saturday with a bunch of different schools. A couple weeks ago, I was here with the Orlando High School, and Esperanza was here, and a bunch of schools from SoCal. We'd like to give a nice warm welcome to Jim Harlan, everybody, from Friends of Jazz.
Dorado High School Jazz Band. My name is Jim, a friend of jazz. I'm going to take a few minutes to tell you about our fantastic nonprofit organization. Our mission is to assure the continued growth and development of jazz music in the schools. And we do it by focusing on education complemented by financial assistance. To date, Friends of Jazz has awarded up to $700,000 in scholarship money to the high school jazz program. And right before the last song today, we're gonna award one scholarship to one of the outstanding players from the Jazz One band today. Now, we're able to do this a couple of ways. With the support of our membership and with the support of the Johnny Carson Foundation. What's that? Did I hear some young people whisper, Johnny who? Who was it that said that? Well, before Fallon and Kimmel and Letterman and Leno and Colbert and all of those people, Johnny Carson was the king of late night TV talk show host. And Johnny Carson loved big bands. You can be part of all this too. You can join Friends of Jazz for as little as $50. And when you give to Friends of Jazz, we give back to you. And we do it. You're invited to all of our jazz concerts through the year, all of our parties, social events and functions. And it's also a great way to connect your student to the jazz world. With our extensive networking capabilities, we can connect your student to a lot of music departments, music programs, music directors, professors, musicians. Great win-win situation. So we're gonna pass out a flyer. It has an application in it. I'm gonna ask you to join Friends of Jazz today. But before you decide, please read about our organization and see the value that we create for the high school jazz program. When you join an organization, you want to know what you're going to get for your money. All about cost versus value. You will see that the value far outweighs the cost. Lastly, this program did not happen the last 2 years, 3 years because of the pandemic. We are thrilled to be here at Main Street Restaurant. And we want to be invited back next year, so thank all of you for ordering food and drinks and more drinks, and remember to tip your server. All right, this could possibly be our best Saturday of 9 different high schools. Gods of the world. Okay, Eric, take us to break.
Put your hands together one more time for Jim Harlan. All right, we have one last tune in this set. Let me give them a quick break to grab some water, and then let me come back and play the hard tunes for you guys. this is a tune entitled Fahn and Andy, written by the local great jazz artist Tom Kubis. We're going to feature Spencer Marr again on the trombone, and Woody Osiszewski on the trombone as well. This is Fahn and Andy. We're going to get things started with our drummer back there, our freshman drummer, Owen Crail. All right, this is Fahn and Andy. Thank you guys very much. Give it up for El Dorado Jazz 1. Here we go. Thank you. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be back in 5 minutes, so don't go anywhere. Thank you guys for being an awesome audience. Have another round of applause for your friends with jazz. We'll be right back. We'll be right back.
We're not done.
Charlie the Whale's first.
Oh, we're not done. We're not done?
What?
We're not done?
Let's
go. Okay, well, I'm going to pause the video and we'll be back for part two. Bye. Part two.
Except for one of them, because they're kind of like our greatest hits. Twos that we've been working on all semester playing at different jazz festivals.
And they're deleted out of your
computer. It'll probably be the last time we play these songs.
What's after Charlie?
Anyways, we're going to start with a tune entitled Charlie the Whale. I know it's for some of our parents, it's one of their favorite tunes. A really great story about this. Can you guys hear me? So we played this twice for Tuffery Middle. Anybody from Tuffery Middle School here? Yeah, I mean, not like currently from Tuffery. You're in college, girl. What's up? Hey, she went to Tuffery, everybody. Yeah. Anyways, so we played this tune a couple times for the Tuffery kids. And I spoke to a parent last night, and she said, man, my son loved that song. He plays tenor saxophone, and he's learning how to play it. And I said, well, I can give you the music if you want. And she goes, no, he made me buy it online. And he's just playing this song every day, which is really cool because I don't think these guys realize how much they inspire the younger students in the middle school. So y'all well done. Right? So, anyways, this is titled Charlie the Whale. And we're here for Joseph Rojas on the tenor saxophone. Kit Kawada on the trumpet. Sam Rahatula on the tenor saxophone. And Adrian Adarlo on the alto saxophone. This is Charlie Whale. Here we go.
Yeah,
here we go.
Okay, I'll go on to you. That sounds good.
One, two. Big down beat. Thank you.
Funk tune that we got just a few years ago when we had Dijon Watson, the great Dijon, on trumpet. Have you guys seen La La Land, the movie La La Land? We were there in the jazz club and there's a big guy playing trumpet. He's a good friend of ours in the program and he gave us this tune to play. It's called For Me to Know. And I forgot. We have a very special guest. Please put your hands together for our principal, Mr. Joey Davis, right over here. Principal of Colorado High School. Loves the attention, so keep it going for Joey Davis, everybody. And his lovely wife Rachel, everybody, keep it going.
Yeah!
Sorry, did I embarrass you enough?
Yeah.
It was great working with everybody, so thank you. Anyways. Well, we're always very thankful for all the support that we get at El Dorado High School from our staff administration. It's really great to have the Davises here joining us for lunch. And they used to come here all the time, am I right, with their family? When this was all open, do you guys remember when this was open? I don't
remember.
It was before my time. We're getting there. We'll have this down there next week. But anyways, thank you, Mr. Vincent Davis, for being here. This tune is entitled For Me to Know. We're going to hear, we just can't get enough of Kent Coato on the trumpet, right?
Yeah.
But we're also going to hear... Is there other flutes in jazz? All right, well, we're going to have Adrian Adarlo on the flute, ladies and gentlemen. We're also going to have Wendy Osaszewski on the trombone. And how about this rhythm section, yeah? Give it up for Jennifer Flores. The bass holding it down. We have Max Bosco and Josh Nine on the piano. We got Itai Niemann on the guitar. And as I mentioned, our freshman drummer, Owen Krill. This is called For Me to Know. Here we go. Jacob Flores. Did I miss him? Jacob Flores on the bass. Hey, Dad. He's forgotten you already, Jacob. That's why. He didn't hear your mother. Oh, shit. Bro, go on. on the trombone. Kent Twan on the trumpet. And Adrian Darrell on the flute.
Lenny, right?
All right, we're going to feature one of our seniors. Well, how many seniors do we have in this band? Stand up if you're a senior. All right, give it up for our seniors. My name is Hassan Hispan. We are now taking applications for new band members. No, we're really excited for them. They've been awesome these past few years. So thank you guys for your hard work and dedication. We're going to have a great rest of the year, yeah? But we're going to feature one of our seniors on the flugelhorn over here. Please put your hands together for Gabe Mollard.
Thank you.
Keep it going for Gabe Ward on the keyboard. All right, well, this next tune is a fun tune by a good friend of mine from Oregon. Check. Oh, that's better. Is that better? That's better. Anyways, the composer I met through the Rio Jazz Festival, this tune is entitled Get It. And there's a couple weeks where I missed school from being out sick, and then I went to a conference, and not necessarily that order, but I told them, just take the solo section and make something out of it. Whatever it is, I'm sure it's going to be cool, and you're going to witness their independent learning and studying on this tune about halfway through. So enjoy. It's not one of those typical jazz tunes, but it's fun nonetheless. We're going to hear from Joseph Rojas on the tenor saxophone, Professor Marvin on the trombone, and I think the rhythm section is going to get down on this tune as well. So, oh yeah, we don't even know yet. All right, so this tune is entitled Get It.
Oh yeah. Oh, I'm just putting the screen on here.
Ready?
I'm good. I don't have any
do your thing, man. I'm just gonna step away.
Oh.
Yeah, here we go. One, two, three.
Thank you.
give it up for these guys one more time. All right, well, we have one more tune for you guys, and before we play, we're going to have a presentation for Friends of Jazz, Jim Harmon, one more time. But I do see a lot of current and former students from El Dorado High School. If you're an alumnus from El Dorado, can you please stand up? Alumni, stand up. I see a couple of you guys out there. Any alumni? Yeah. Any current students out there from El Dorado High School? Yeah? Oh, they're all outside. Oh, hey, guys. Welcome. All right, well, man, it's so great to be here with you guys and play some live music, have some great food. I don't know for you guys, but for me, there's nothing like live music. Yeah, just being in the mix of things and just hearing it, because once these guys play the tune, it's not recorded, we can't go back and watch. I mean, we can watch it again on video, but it's just not the same. But to have live music in our lives is certainly a pleasure. And thank you guys for experiencing this with us and giving us the opportunity to share our music, not only with these guys, but with jazz too as well. So thank you guys for being an awesome audience, and give yourselves a round of applause. Give these guys a round of applause. Yeah. All right, at this time we're going to bring back the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Jim Harlan from Friends of Jazz.
Well, Eric, I have some bad news for you.
Uh-oh.
No scholarship again this year for you.
Oh.
I'm going to work on an honorary scholarship or something for you.
With interest.
You know, there's an intangible I look at when I see a performance from high school jazz bands. It's an intangible element. It's hard to define. It's either on or it's off. And it's the relationship between the band director and the performer, the player. And I can tell you, with this band, it's on. We got one hell of a band director here, Eric. We've been seeing him for years, and we want to start giving money away. We want to give $500 to the high school jazz program at El Dorado. Is awarded the El Dorado High School Jazz Band in recognition of outstanding achievement in jazz performance. Thank you, El Dorado High School. A lot of moving pieces go into giving the scholarship. El Dorado makes it very difficult because of the level of performer here, and there's a lot of skill out there. We recognize that. We look at achievement, accomplishment, excellence, command of the instrument, dedication, sacrifice, all of those things that go into making, you know, a tremendous scholarship winner for Friends of Jazz. There's one person here today that caught our eye. We like their vibe, the dynamics from this person. And Friends of Jazz is honored to award a $500 scholarship. That's to your killer bass player.
Say thanks again for being out here. Don't forget, on June 3rd, Friday night, in the Performing Arts Center right at El Dorado High School, the great Francisco Torres is going to be playing with us on trombone. Pancho Sanchez on percussion. And with this band, with Jazz 2 and Jazz 3, it's going to be an awesome night of music, a night of Latin jazz, a lot of swing happening, but it's just going to be a great night to be back in the pack, jamming on some tunes. Well, thank you very much. Hey, give a round of applause for Main Street Restaurant for having us. One more time, friends of Jazz over here. Thank you so much. My name is Eric Sampson. This is Eldorado Jazz 1, and this is a tune that we've been closing out our sets with, entitled Musicality Knows. We're going to hear from Just Ross again on the tenor saxophone, and back there on the drums, Mr. Owen Krill. This is Eldorado Jazz 1. Thank you very much. Have a great afternoon.
Okay. Hey, squeeze in, you guys squeeze in.
He wants us to get the stains out of the way first.
What?
He wants us to get the stains out of the way first.
Hello.
Josh, get in the picture. Set up. Jake, come down here. Can I come down here with us?
Yeah. Don't put this off to the side really quick.
What's up?
Woo!
Dude, wow.
The
whole thing.
How long is that?
Probably like an hour and 20 minutes. No, this is the second set. This is just the second set.
Back row back here on the step, you're gonna have a seat.
I guess I'm gonna
be crouch down. Yeah, crouch down.
Alright, you wanna say peace? I'm done.
Hey, Brian, put the seat.